In this tutorial, I'll show you how you can approach creating a template in PowerPoint by being consistent, using the same elements, and brainstorming on how you can change the design to make a consistent and cohesive template which will be working together. In a few minutes, I've created three slides which are consistent and they could be produced towards a ready and finished template. Hello everyone! A student suggested that it would be useful to have a lesson about how to create actually templates in PowerPoint, how to approach them, how to think of some designs, and I'll show you right now how you can, for example, do this. Now, let me get a clean slide because I want to do something completely custom. Please head over to Insert, Shapes, and select the triangle, the very simple triangle. Okay, once you have it, I'll press my left shift key to make the triangle equal. And I'll make a triangle like that. You can do the same one. Now, once you have the triangle, please go to Edit Shape and select Edit Points. At first, you want to right-click on each point and select Smooth Point, Smooth Point, Smooth Point. This is only to get us going. Now I'll make the triangle a bit smaller. You should make the same so we have a nice rounded object. Now, once you finish that, change all points to straight points, because if smooth point is selected and I pull this handle, it grows in both ways. I want to customize this shape to be unnatural and not so equal. So we need to change it to straight point, straight point, straight point. Okay, now I can tinker just a little bit around with this. Let's say I'll make the shape like this, or maybe a bit smaller. Then I place this a bit here. This will come a bit closer, a bit stronger. Oh, sorry, you can do this. You need to manipulate the handles separately. Okay, I'll pull this back a little bit to the left, and the right side should stay like this. I'll click away, and this is my PowerPoint template. How complicated. Now, let's rotate it with the shift key to an equal amount, and I'll simply rotate it to the side a little bit. It's a bit too large, sorry. I'll make it smaller, and let's say this is the basics for the entire template and the entire PowerPoint slide you want to create. At first, I want a different color. I want it to be gray. So I'll go to Shape Outline, No Outline, Shape Fill, and I want to select a gray color. Let's select more fill colors, go to black, and select a darkish gray color, something like this. Okay, this is my example shape. Now, I've prepared an icon. I've downloaded it from FreePic. It's a great icon, an online store free icon. And I'll credit this icon by showcasing it because I think it's a really beautiful icon. But let me show you an example. Now, I want this online store, for example, to be in my slide. It doesn't have to fit perfectly into this object because I want this template to really give me freedom of designing. And I want this icon to showcase like this. So in the background, you see that something is going on, but it doesn't have to be always the same way. Now I'll copy this object. Let me make it smaller, and maybe you want to explain 3 points on this slide. No problem. 1, 2, 3, you have 3 objects. Select all of the objects, go to Format, and in the Align panel, select 2 options. Align Center and Distribute Vertically. Now, you have prepared your objects. If you would like to change the colors, you can change the colors. My trick on doing this to simply change the colors is also right-clicking, Format Shaping, opening the fill, and working with transparency. Let's make it 20%, 21 is okay. Transparency number 2, 35, okay. And this is dark gray, lighter gray, and even lighter gray. So this would be essentially my template. Now I want to add a simple title. I'll simply insert text box and insert a text box like that. Slide title. Let me select a different font because the Calibri original is too plain and too simple. I feel like Leto font should be okay. Let's go to Leto. Leto black for the title, of course. This is the slide title. Bigger to the side. Boom, it slowly gets better. Okay, now the last thing would be to fill out the points. I would go to Insert, Text Box, and I would create 3 equal text boxes. Let me select some lorem ipsum text Okay, I've pasted the text. Now again, since I'm running with Leto, let me go to Leto, but this time not black. Do I want hairline? Do I want light? Yes, I think I want light. I want it to be smaller and I want to justify it. So justify, smaller, and this is it. Now take this text box, Control V, and this is exactly how I would approach a custom slide design like this. Now watch on the left side and here in the middle, this looks really, really amazing and beautiful. Now you can argue about the slide distribution which I made, but I've kept the right side simple. And let's say I have another slide. Boom, boom, this on the other side, like that. Rotate this around, place it like this. The online icon here, or a different icon if you have. You can leave the title here or place the title on the other side. Boom, boom. My approach on doing templates is to have a consistent design. By consistent design, I'll mean I'll use the same font over and over again and the same objects over and over again. Let's say I'll copy this object, new slide, Control V. Now I have this object. I can duplicate, I can rotate it by an equal amount, and let's say that you would insert a picture here. This would be also very cool because these are not lungs. Let me say I'll use a different picture from a previous tutorial. So I would use a picture. Let me send it to back. Now what I would do, I would select the image, select the shape, I would go to format options, and the older versions didn't have this, but PowerPoint 2013 and 2016 has the merge options, so I would simply intersect it. You see, I've intersected the image, and since I'll be inserting images in this template, I want to make sure that I'm using the same object in the background. I could even do something like this. Let me get back to it. How was it rotated? Was it like that? Okay, let me make this bigger. Send to back. Then I would copy some text, copy some objects. Boom. On this side, maybe this would be deleted. This text would be in the middle. It would be bigger. And as you can see, I am being consistent within this template. Now, I don't think this quite looks as good as I promised it to be, but you get the idea. You would need to do some additional changes in order to make it really, really cool and appealing, but this is how you can approach custom templates. And you see, we created 3 slides in a matter of few minutes. I don't quite like this. Let's approach it like that. Okay, and you can always watch in the preview if those slides go well along with each other. I would make this image bigger, I believe, so the entire slide in the end would look like that. This looks really interesting, and we always use the same shape, and we are going towards a template.